Hello everyone, welcome back for more of the Game Boy's first year releases retrospective for Nintember. Today is a game I could find almost no actual information on. Boomer's Adventures in Asmik World. The blurb I got said he was the last warrior, and if he was the last actual warrior, I can see why he's the last one. He ain't much of a fighter. Yep, this is another puzzle game. And your abilities are kind of limited. You have a timer ticking down constantly, which is a problem because you've got to find things. This first stage is fairly straightforward. You have a key. You have a door. That's all you need. You need to find the key and use it to open the door. The problem is the keys are, from now on, going to be buried. And to unearth the key, you dig a hole. Now imagine this key was buried somewhere on the screen. Yeah, you begin to see the problem. So, let's look at the UI here. You have your point totals. You have the little symbol that says, hey, you have the key. You have the stage number, you have your timer, and then those three blobs underneath the timer are your lives. So open the door with the key. And now we get a stage that's going to have some enemies crawling around on it. And what complicates things is the enemies will also be digging, and if they find the key, you have to beat them for it. This is a compass. If you look in the upper right, you have a little compass symbol. I know roughly where the key is this time. The compass will point you in the direction of the key, but it only has so many uses. And if you get touched by an enemy, then you lose the key and have to do this all over again. He dug up a compass. If we managed to drop him down a pit, he would drop that compass to us. But you have to drop him down a pit, and they dig exactly as fast as you do. So if you get in a digging contest, you give it up, you've lost. Okay, let's see. All the way over there. And yes, all these things you see scattered around are items that you will want to have. And you can fall in your own pits. I do not recommend doing this. Nope, can't go that way. The bone here, you grab once and you have one shot to throw it and kill an enemy, which will respawn at the stairs you came back in, I believe. Now see, I've played these stages before, that's why I'm doing so well now. I need to leave the little transmitter there, because that's the only way we know where to go. Damn it. Nope. I have no idea how to decipher the bleeps they transmit. I know the louder it is, the closer you are to something. Oh, there we go. Found the key. The transmitter works for anything buried, which is a problem because there are a lot of things buried in the ground. I'm going to try to finish this game before I hit the game over, or try to finish this recording. Screen has some very nasty flashing lights. And of course he got me. So it's over in that little area. I just didn't have the chance to go actual dig there because enemies. They don't really home in on you. They just kind of do things. If you do see them dig up the key, then feel free to take it from them if you can. If you hang around on the stage long enough, they will uncover the key for you. Like that. He found the key. Good for him. So we let him do our dirty work for us. Dang it. I think that was the key right there. Could have been. I didn't get a good enough look at it. That was just a compass. Damn it. Okay. Before we continue, I'm not going to continue because if I die here, we hit a major need for an epilepsy warning because, for whatever reason, the game over scroll flickers and flashes like you wouldn't believe. So I'm going to stop here before we hit the game over screen because it hurt my eyes to watch it. I can't imagine what it was due to someone with photosensitive epilepsy. So, you get the idea. The key's buried somewhere on the stage. You gotta go find it. It's not a bad little puzzle game, but I wish I could find more information on it. Yeah, it's you get items, and I'm not sure if the boomerang is only supposed to have three uses. Because from what I read, there are bosses that you need to smack with the boomerang and the bones. And some of them take more than 10 hits. Eh. But yeah, that's enough of Boomer for now. Okay, Boomer, there's the joke. Haha, funny. Anyway, yeah, tomorrow, something else. For now, this has been Boomer. I would recommend playing it, unless you are photosensitive epileptic. In which case, never hit a game over if you try to play this, because I don't think it'll do good things for you. So until then, take care, everyone.